Hello, and welcome to this video about pyramids. In this video, we will explore different types of pyramids and how to calculate their volume and surface area. Let's learn about pyramids. We cannot talk about pyramids without mentioning the most famous pyramids in the world, located in Egypt and built as a tomb for Egyptian kings. Although pyramids are not quite common, their shape is so striking that it seems it is used to make a statement. Perhaps that is the reason the Egyptian kings used it as their tomb. The Louvre Museum in Paris, which is the largest art museum in the world, is also shaped like a pyramid. As you can see from the images of the Egyptian pyramids, a pyramid is a three-dimensional figure with triangular sides that meet at the edges and at the top to form an apex, and it has a polygon as its base. The polygon base determines the type of pyramid. Here you see the pyramid with a triangle as its base is a triangular pyramid. The pyramid with a rectangle as its base is a rectangular pyramid, and the pyramid with a pentagon as its base is a pentagonal pyramid. We also have hexagonal pyramids and heptagonal pyramids and so on. Let's take a moment and recall what the volume and surface area of a three-dimensional figure means. The volume of a three-dimensional figure is the measure of how much it can hold, and it is measured in cubic units. The surface area of a three-dimensional figure is the measure of the total area that the surface of the figure covers, and it is measured in square units. Before we can calculate the volume and surface area of a pyramid, we must know the difference between the height and slant height. The height of a pyramid is the perpendicular length from the apex to the base, and the slant height is the length from the apex to the midpoint of the bottom edge of one of the triangular faces. Here are the formulas for the volume and surface area of any pyramid. To calculate the volume and surface area of any pyramid, we need big B, which represents the area of the base, and P, which represents the perimeter of the base. It is important to note, since the base of a pyramid can be any polygon, we will be using our prior knowledge of finding the area and perimeter of different polygons to calculate the volume and surface area of a pyramid. Volume equals 1/3 big B times H, and surface area equals big B plus 1/2 PS, where big B is the area of the base, H is the height of the pyramid, P is the perimeter of the base, and S is the slant height. Let's look at an example. A triangular pyramid has an equilateral triangle as its base with side length 6 inches and a height of 8 inches. What is the volume and surface area of the pyramid? To find the surface area of a pyramid, we use the formula surface area is equal to big B plus 1/2 PS, where big B is the area of the base, P is the perimeter of the base, and S is the slant height. Since the base is a triangle, we will use the formula for the area of a triangle to find big B. Area of a triangle is equal to 1/2 BH, where the B and H are the base and height of the triangular base. We will draw a perpendicular line to the base, which is the height of the triangular base, and it divides the base of the triangle into two equal parts. Since the triangle is now turned into two right triangles, we can use the Pythagorean theorem to find the height. So the Pythagorean theorem is C squared equals a squared plus b squared. And then we're going to look at our triangle, which says we have 6 squared for the hypotenuse is equal to h squared plus 3 squared. 6 squared is 36 equals h squared plus 9. We'll subtract 9 from both sides. This gives us 27 is equal to h squared. And then we'll square root both sides, which gives us h is equal to 3/3, or h is approximately equal to 5.2. Therefore, the area of the base can be found by doing a equals 1/2 bh, where b is equal to 6, and h is equal to 5.2. which is equal to approximately 15.6 square inches. The perimeter of the base is equal to all the sides added together. So 6 plus 6 plus 6, which equals 18 inches. Now to solve for surface area, all we have to do is plug these values in for our variables. So our surface area is equal to area of the base, which we found to be 15.6, plus 1/2 times the perimeter, which is 18, times the slant height, which we were given, which is 7. And all this added together is approximately equal to 78.6 square inches. To find the volume of the triangular pyramid, we need the area of the base, big B, and the height of the pyramid, which is 8 inches. So let's plug this in. So volume is equal to 1/3 area of the base times the height. So 1/3 times 15.6 times 8, because our height was given. Now all we have to do is calculate this out, which is equal to approximately 41.6 cubic inches. Let's look at another example. Here is a pyramid with a square base with side lengths of 5 centimeters. The height of the pyramid is 11 centimeters. What is the volume of the pyramid? So our volume formula is 1/3 big B, area of the base, times the height. Before we can calculate the volume of the pyramid, we need to find the area of the base. Since the base is a square, we use the formula for the area of a square, which is S squared. So to find our area, we're going to use S squared, and our side length is 5. So 5 squared is equal to 25 square centimeters. Now we can plug this value into our formula. So we have 1/3 times 25 times our height is 11. Then if we plug this into a calculator, we'll get that it's approximately equal to 91.67 cubic centimeters. But when would we ever need this in real life? Well, I'm glad you asked. Take a look at this next example and try it on your own. The roof of a wooden cottage is shaped like a square-based pyramid. The length of the sides of the square base are 22 feet, and the height of the triangular face is 14 feet. Peter wants to paint the roof of his wooden cottage and needs to determine how much paint he needs to buy. We will assume 1 pint of paint covers 400 square feet. How much paint does Peter need to buy? The roof of the cottage does not include the base of the pyramid. Therefore, we only need to find the area of the 4 triangular bases. This is called the lateral area. So the lateral area is equal to the surface area minus the area of the base. So all we need is 1/2 PS. So we have 1/2 times the perimeter of our square, which is equal to 4 times the side length. So 4 times 22 times our slant height, which is 14, which we can plug into a calculator to get 616. So we will need 616 square feet to be covered. If 1 pint of paint covers 400 square feet, we need to divide 616 by 400 to figure out how much paint we need. So 616 divided by 400 is equal to 1.54. So Peter will need to buy 2 pints of paint to cover the roof of the cottage, because 1 pint won't be enough and you can't get 0.54 of a pint. So 2 pints of paint will cover the whole roof. I hope this video on finding the volume and surface area of a pyramid is helpful. Thanks for watching and happy studying.